song?
Yes, it is. Thank you, and thank you for getting this opportunity to pitch. It's a rare thing, so please excuse me if I'm fumbling a little bit. These are hard acts to follow, I must say. I find it difficult to look at my sheet and find something that hasn't been said. But I'll try anyway. I think what differentiates us from many others is that we are truly seed stage. We are early stage. It's what we do and it's what we're good at. We have a partnership with a local pre-seed innovation environment, which is publicly funded, and it enables us to invest super early. We are a very active VC investor. We invested in 20 tech companies just last year. Lots of them very exciting. Of course, all of them very exciting, actually. But I think if you look at any VC company, and this has been said before, check out the persons behind. None of us at Seed are bankers. I think that actually goes for all of us. So again, it's roughly the same. But my own background, I'm a PhD originally. I worked in corporate for a while and did not like it. I joined NetDoctor, which was probably my most intense startup experience ever. I worked there for 5 years. I joined just before the dot-com crash. We crashed and burned and spent a lot of money. And then after that, it was sort of a turbo business development, reorganizations. I learned hiring and firing without crying, speedy business development, and lots of things that you experience in daily startup life. I've been there and I understand what you go through. In fact, we all do. My next day job after Seed, after NetDoctor was Seed Capital. I joined roughly 9 years ago. It seems like a short while, but it's been many years. I think this is the best job in the world, and I agree to some that has been said. It's very privileged. It's a fantastic honor to work with you guys. I get challenged every day, and it's fantastic. Some of you might say that, well, this guy hasn't really started his own startup. I've been a part of startups, and I've worked in corporate, worked in VC, but has he started his own? No, I haven't. But I did sail around the world with my family for 2 years before joining Seed, and I regard that as my little successful startup. It has several similarities. First of all, you have to be a little bit crazy to do it. Secondly, team is absolutely essential, and you need a skipper, i.e. a CEO, to make this work. If the shit hits the fan, you need somebody in charge. At the same time, as you all know in a family, you need to have consensus and make sure that everybody is motivated, otherwise things explode. And if you think co-founder dynamics can be difficult, just imagine yourself with your wife and 2 kids in the middle of an ocean, high seas, sweltering heat, and penned up in a space that's like a dorm room. MVP is also great for you. If anybody has sailed, will know that seasons are quite important for you. If you are a little bit late for a weather window, you're not just a little bit delayed, you will be a year delayed. So sometimes you have to make a deadline regardless, right? And so get that product out the door regardless. The third thing I really learned was perseverance and focus. It's a long journey, but you can make it if you have, you know, the long-term goal in mind and focus on the little steps and just aggressively overcome them. So I do think I know where you are, and I do think that I can sort of empathize whenever you are crying a little bit. Some of the stuff we're looking for. Before I tell you about that, I would actually say that as a pre-seed investor, it's a fantastic privilege to be able to actually invest stuff early and get hands-on experience in sectors we find interesting. So if you have, FinTech is one of the areas we like, everybody does. But we actually invested very early in blockchain technology. We were the first Danish investor to invest in that area, in Coinify. They're actually doing quite well right now, but they might have been a fantastic failure. But we've learned hands-on and can get that experience onto you if you have a fintech startup that can benefit from, you know, their experience. So we don't just read reports and analysts, we invest. Another area that we like is the digitalization and consumerization of healthcare. Fantastic area. I've been there with NetDoctor many years ago. We did lots of stuff right, but we were just way too early. This is a sector that's going to explode. If you have something that's interesting there, I think it, in Christian's words, will actually mean something to people and will change the way we live our lives. AI was mentioned by Chris. Unfortunately, I have not worked with Marvin Minsky, but I find it a really, really interesting area.
Please give it up.